In the old days, it was commonplace to save text as a graphic. As you can see here, that doesn't scale well visually and adds to the page weight and latency. Text as graphic can also cause conflicts with format choice. Now, in theory, you might want to save text in a PNG format because text has solid color and hard edges. But in this example, we've saved as a JPEG because we're using text over a photo. Scale that up and you start to see artifacts. Using text as a graphic also means the text can't be found by search engines and isn't accessible by screen readers and other assistive technologies. You can see what the current page looks like in the text-only browser links. That gives a good idea of what screen readers and search engine web crawlers see. All you can see here is the alt text on the image, which says koala, nothing else. And you can't copy text as graphic either. If you do need to incorporate text and graphics, overlay real text over the top. Simple. Both the photo and the text display and scale much better. And you can select the text. And it's really easy to add effects with CSS. I'm using the lovely Lobster font, which is one of the many free web fonts available. File size is smaller too, because we can save the photo as a nice small JPEG for the photo, rather than having to use PNG to cope with text. On the subject of text and images, one way to ensure your site is really responsive is not to have any images at all. Maybe some of the pages on your website don't need images. These sites use beautiful typography, CSS effects, and great layout to achieve really striking graphical effects with responsive layouts and stonkingly fast load times. Likewise, these sites which use images really sparingly. When you're designing a responsive site, every time you add a placeholder for an image, think about whether you really need it. Sometimes the best image is no image at all. In the past, typography on the web was extremely limited by the number and quality of fonts available. With web fonts and modern CSS implementations, that's all changed. Web fonts and CSS enable beautiful typography on the web without having to resort to using text as graphics.